Looked like they covered a considerable amount of ground yesterday, but really it was just a lie because I didn't collect the deadwood or the 2.5s. And I'm gonna tidy it all up this morning because I like it perfect. Because professionalism is, that's what I want.
Before you dare, he's gonna get stopped by the guards for having green diesel and no tax and insurance. I said, oh, can't stop you, and I'll just say, hey, you know who we are? Do you see these arms? You see them? You want to be put through a fucking wall, do you?
You think you're a big deal, don't you?
You think your arms are big?
No, I don't.
Cars won't mind you not wearing
you just
seatbelts.
You have to take
them. No tax insurance. Green diesel. Trucks in the back.
Oh.
What? It's not a pedestrian crossing. You can drive over her and you won't get in trouble.
A roll there in Mulroney's in Templemore. So there's Mulroney's fucking everywhere you turn now.
Didn't even know us.
There's Grandma, man. Didn't even see us.
Terrified to talk to you with your big arms.
Fuck you, Dad.
Oh, shit. They're here, Greg. Cars are here for you.
No way.
Yeah, I fucking know exactly why. You think you can drive around Templemore, the home of the guards, with them fucking weapons out?
Big head.
Fuck you, Greg. They're gonna come over and arrest you.
Go on, buy him something.
What do you want?
Treat me.
I'll treat you. Sorry I wasn't on last night. I was just so busy. I don't know whether it's because of Father's Day or it's a wedding season or loads of birthdays, but I ended up just doing personal messages for people all night. I'm gonna have to stop doing that because it's not the most productive way to spend my time when I should be at home. Got up at 5 o'clock this morning, went up the mountain, done my cycle, which was nice. But I came back here now, I have to take Clark to training. And then I have shed loads of stuff to do for Vicky, for work. I have to go collect parts and then I do stuff for myself. But I'm sorry I'm taking time putting up the hats, but I'm just going to do everything on the one day. And I was waiting for my new t-shirts. Look at that. New Bastard Crow t-shirt, sexy as dick, screen printed. Now, awesome. Isn't that now? Come on. See? It's deadly. And there's a couple more t-shirts and then all new stickers and I'm going to put them up on Monday, so sorry about the way. I am fucked.
Back to the little man there, we're going to go to training. But wait till I tell you this. So I got in contact with Sony the day before yesterday and I went rogue on him. I'd done something I didn't want to do. I went down the road of saying that if they didn't do something for me, I was going to really, really slate them. Worse than I have been on social media. And I got in contact with their supervisor and their supervisor rang me back and I explained to him what happened and that this is going on 2 months and that I'm paying for membership and I have no PlayStation and I'm getting just sent around in circles. Anyway, they rang me back and they said, look, we're going to send you out a new PlayStation. It's not your fault and it was in our care, blah, blah, blah. And I got a confirmation email then saying, your PlayStation will be sent out within 4 to 5 working days. And I was delighted. I was so buzzing. Wasn't I, Clark? So happy. And then I got another email saying that UPS are sending it out. Enjoy yourself. What are you going to do? I love that chat. I am truly ready for anything now. Any hole that has to be drilled, any screw that has to be screwed, connect shit to it. Cowering, feel so manly. Oh, really, really dark grey chicken! I get asked to do a lot of fucking weird shit, but I've never actually been commissioned to draw as lifelike a penis as I possibly can. In fact, what it says here is the best penis I can possibly draw in 15 minutes on an A4 piece of paper. Normally I'd go like, I'm not a performing monkey. But when there's this much money involved, I just requested payment and the payment has just went through. So it's penis drawing time. It turns out that you can draw a penis, even a highly detailed one, very quickly. And if you're gonna spend 15 minutes at it, you'd spend a lot of time at shading, veins, hairs, little imperfections, etc., etc.
So there is a pretty detailed weird penis heading off to Norway. It's definitely a man too. So, you know, I hope you enjoy it. Hope you enjoy that. I don't know what that says about Norway men, but you know, I don't care. No judgment here.
Little bit of a change in the weather. Nippy.
That's not nippy, but it was a little chilly, breezy, so. Not hard to go up tomorrow. Gonna have a good weekend. Imagine it's the longest day of the year. Fucking year's fucked, isn't it? I'm still in half lockdown. Joke. Green mess. I don't know. Burnt my mouth there. The mug's too good. They're fucking terrible, actually. Terrible fucking good.
I didn't know it was Amazon Prime Day. Look at that. It's like gold, hardwood. Today, for me, is get out as much as you can before it rains day. Anyway, I don't need anything. I have everything I need for now. Just. Well, let's not forget that there isn't that many men like me out there. But at this job, you can make from 4 to 11 million yen a year. Of course, I'm on the high end of that. So, it's been crossed to bear. Good news for you if you're one of these many so-called hard-working men that aren't afraid of hard work. That I get so many messages off. You don't need these highly skilled jobs to make these 11 million yens a year. What you could do is take two normal jobs, because let's face it, most jobs now, 28 to 34 hours a week. Just get two of them. There's loads of hours in a day, plenty more of them in a week. Just work hard, get up off your fanny that you call a dick, and do so. Make your life better. Why not? Why wouldn't you? You've not better to do.
The new GT3 Porsche. It's just, it's a thing of beauty, and yeah, if not that, maybe just a new M5. I can take Clark and the kids with me while I give it a whip around. I'm pretty sure you meant to ask the question, how did you make it an art working a crane at 100%? I'm nearly 100% sure that's what you meant to say. 100%. I only ever work at 100%.
That's a question that I'm slowly coming to terms with myself. Since the social media thing became a business, I tend to do 55 to 62 hours on the machine. And I don't work Saturdays, and I try to get home, spend time with the kids in the evening. I also have the hours that I'm doing this, and that's busy enough. That can be up to 28 to 32 hours a week. There's a nice bit to it. You might take me to a shop, you have orders, and you have emails, and then there's editing. And busy, but busy's good.
Apple products have become more expensive as well, and I don't think the head of Apple is tearing over to China to offer the factory workers more money. Unfortunately, the rate is the rate and it doesn't follow the market, so us poor little contractors have to just watch in despair.
What I'm planning on doing is getting a crowbar and thinking of jamming it in there as hard as they can, moving it around like this, like if you're putting down a fence pole, and then just pouring it in. It's the only way to do it. It's the only way, unfortunately. It's just that no other choice. Just.
Friday I'm getting it, and I'm looking forward to getting it over and done with. And no, before anyone asks, I'm not worried about side effects or any other stupid things. I'm not going to get all righteous now about what drugs I put in my body. Some people are such hypocrites.
Very simple. It's a supply and demand issue. And when mills and shops can get top dollar for their product, they're going to get it.
So there's a couple of issues together making it just the perfect storm. There's more new homes being built all over the world. And so demand goes up. Then you have COVID and factories going and mills, you know, not up to full capacity. And then if you think about everyone's attitude during lockdown, how many people do you know had to stay at home and they built like deccans and done their fences? And then think about all the pubs and restaurants that had to build outdoor areas. So that's extra timber going out of the system. So if you add all that together worldwide, there's just a supply and demand problem.
2009, it went down to Morrison's in Cairn and got a full service and a health check, and it said that it might need a camshaft seal at some stage, and I parked it after that and passed its NCT. Now it's going to need a lot now. All the rubber stuff is going to need to be changed. But
so I would absolutely consider doing that, but the problem is no machinery company is going to pay me to tell the truth. Unless you're going to lick their balls and tell everyone that the product is brilliant, they have no interest. We'll leave that to grass, man. I'll stay in my lane. They were sending me out a new one. I was really happy. Took a lot of work to get to that stage. And then I got an email saying that UPS are sending out the new one. So the chances of that actually getting to me are slim and none.
Awesome dream! Vicky's absolutely disgusted because I just spent the last few minutes putting on my new stickers. There's me fuck up fairy one. It's one of my favourite quotes that I only made up last week. I made that sticker, to be fair, just to annoy certain people. And I can tell you now, the fox that we're talking about isn't saying much at this time. And there's my new Stone Cold Cowboy sticker. Fuck your feelings. And of course, finger. And last but not least, cunt of a man sticker. Cunt of a man. Vicky's giving out to me here. Yeah, so I've just bought up the t-shirts. The cunt of a man t-shirt. Vicky's favourite.
Yeah, I love that word.
And the fuck up fairy. And the new Battle Crow. And I have the sun hat and the baseball caps up and the new stickers and the pens. Now, we haven't sent out boxes and stuff before, so we're learning as we go. So bear with us with the hats because we want to make sure that they're packaged right, because we don't want to get them damaged. So yeah, they're up on it now. Sorry it took so long. What are you doing?
Tidying up.
I'm not finished.
You.
You're always tidying before I finish, like.
Because you're like a little, I don't know.
Go.
You're not.
Yeah, think yeah. You are. Anyway, they're up on it now.
Morning, son. Nice to see you.
Forgot my coffee mug in the car. She wasn't long coming up. Looks like it's going faster, but no, I can assure you it's the same speed every morning. 28.6 kilometers per second. Lucy. She's deaf as a sheep.
How beautiful a morning is that? You know, it was actually nice to see the roads were really busy this morning. And they've been getting busy, so things are getting back to normal. And you know, that's actually a question people have asked me over the last couple of years. Is it not dangerous driving early in the morning? And funny enough, the data is very, very clear on that. From 11:30 at night until 6:30 in the morning is the safest time to drive on the road. Which is weird considering, if you take a year, it's probably when visibility is at its worst, weather conditions, people should be tired, maybe they're up early or haven't went to bed at all. But none of that is clear. 11:30 at night till 6:30 in the morning, safest time to drive. I'm pretty sure it's a weird happen chance thing that that's when the least amount of women are on the road. I'm not saying that has anything got to do with it. That's why I'm 100% I am not saying that. But I am saying that, the data doesn't lie. Sorry ladies, what can I say? I'm a cunt of a man. what a delicious, nutritious, filling breakfast. Oh, that's Greg's so annoying today. He's such an annoying bastard. Look at that. You look at the big brain Cody head on it.
Put away, you cunt.
Greg thinks he's great now because he's
cunt of a
his
man.
Fuck up! His men. His men won the 2020 Junior B Championship Sunday.
Yep.
You're so happy, aren't you?
I'm fucking happy, yeah.
Is it true that you said if they won and gave it their all, they could touch your arms?
No, that's not true. Dave, stop.
Did that happen?
Stop it now.
Oi. Because
I'm getting my tea.
You know what I was most impressed over?
What?
You were on every sub. Oh, great man. Glorious leader.
Did you finish getting up on the timber yesterday when I wasn't here?
I was talking to David Fitz this morning.
David, you're going to fuck off what you said now. Hey!
Anyway, Davey said to me, he said, look David, I'd ring Greg with myself, but I fear him as much as I respect him.
In a bottle, like a lemonade bottle, and said, then they
just to tell Greg,
urinate on it over
that,
a couple
just,
of days.
What's that?
Leave it just kind of...
He said that he feels that you should be the King of Ireland.
David, eat your lunch.
I am.
Shut up.
I'm enjoying it.
Turn it now.
You're in such bad form.
You would go anywhere in bed for that.
I have my vaccination on Friday, and I was just telling Greg that I'm getting the Pfizer one. And what one did you get?
Modern.
And Greg said my one is worse because not only do they use a bigger needle, when they're administering it,
you have to be lying down.
You have to be lying down, and they shove two fingers up your hole. So, I don't know, I'm kind of looking forward to it now. Can't believe it. Look at that. See that load of timber? That load of timber is worth so much money. I am just amazed that Don Toretto and his racially diverse gang of thieves have pulled up beside me trying to rob it, trying to hijack it, carjack it, whatever they do. Fast and Furious 10, the timber heist. Fuck you, Don. Fuck you and your family. Come here. Little Grumpy Pants is going to bed very, very soon. And when she does, then we'll get Clamp to bed, and then me and you. What are we going to do?
A few orders,
probably. We'll do a few orders to catch up with the chickies at work.
She sings it, hold on, and it goes a little more.
Oh, you're some dancer. Yay! Great singing! Awesome! Yeah, I have fucking a load out already, and he's not even here. Such a sharp, drug pain in my back from carrying these bastards. Farmers are gonna be delayed. They're gonna be buzzing. Fuck pissing rain. This weather is gonna cause me problems today. I feel the ground is just getting soft. So last night it was about 10:15 by the time I got into the office to start doing orders. And I got 35 done, so bear with me, I'll get there. And I really appreciate all the support that you give me here. Fucking awesome, I love you all. But I was going through the orders and an address came up on it. I was there, this can't be right. It was Gnawbone, as in Gnawbone, Indiana. I was there like, this has to be wrong. Couldn't be right. So the number was on it, so I rang the guy. Big shout out to Zane, I think it was. Can't think of your second name now, sorry. But yeah, an Illuminati member. But I can tell you, after a very interesting conversation with him, tell you the Illuminati member. Sorry, ran out of time. Yeah, the Illuminati members over on this side of the Atlantic have it way handier than they do over in the US. In the land of the free and the home of the brave, if you have money, you're free, and if you don't, you had better be brave. Because it's sort of like our forestry industry in Ireland. If you want to compete, you have to invest a large amount of monies in equipment, etc., etc. And there is no grants, there is no state subsidies. Like over there, if you're an Illuminati member, if your land's not making money, or you have a bad year because of rain, snow, whatever reason, you're just screwed. Ain't going running back to the government. Bank man will be at your door. Yeah, it's fucking tough. Lovely lad. I don't know what he looked like. He could have been gorgeous, he could have been sexy, maybe he wasn't, I don't know, but he was a lovely fucking lad. Interesting conversation. Granted, I eat a lot of apples, but I would really prefer if this shit stopped happening to me. Look at that. So embarrassed. As you know, I'm the CEO of an international e-commerce business, and I have the other stuff. I have the other stock, I have the other packaging, stationery. And yesterday I rang this crowd, wrapping, packaging, whatever. I was talking to a guy named Greg. He was getting prices for me, fierce nice fella. And me, Greg, Gareth, my friends, my brothers, we have a way of communicating with each other. It's boisterous at best. And I was getting out of the machine just to come over and get my lunch, and Greg's name came up on the phone, and I went, "What the fuck do you want, dickhead?" And then I heard silence, followed by, I have prices back for that package. I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. I thought you were my brother. I apologize for that.
today's lunch is, we'll say it's a solid 6 out of 10. It's on a white bread with a yellowish hint to it. There is chicken, cheese, and ham with a little bit of Ballymaloe reddish. It's not bad. It's not bad. It's a solid 6. Solid 6. I think that she should have trimmed off the excess pieces of ham and put them into the bread. It would have made it just that little bit more aesthetically pleasing. But, you know, we'll let it slide. She wasn't home till 11:30 last night. And, you know, I was in bed, so I wasn't there to tell her where she was making her mistakes. But, you know, it was, if she had done that, it would have been definitely 7.5 out of 10. You know, it was a missed opportunity on her behalf, if I'm honest. But, you know, you can't win them all. You can't win them all.
Yes, Greg. There's no other man be able to lift that down.
I was afraid I was going to spill it on me.
No, not you, Greg. No, not the power you have in them arms. Just tell him he can't talk to his employee like that.
No, you can do what I like
to you. No, you can't. Could you lick me out?
You're my bitch.
Well, then lick me out. Oh, look. That's what I looks like when it hasn't been changed in 8,000 hours.
There's not fucking 8,000 hours on it.
Yeah, what? Where will I get it?
No, we're down here.
Your small toolbox. Your small screwdriver.
We're here.
I'll tell you now.
Do you use it for that?
That's what I use it for. What's the grand fitted overalls you have there, guy?
A big fat man gave me this.
Who?
Just there's a big fat man. I can't mention names because he could get upset.
That's way too big for you.
He knows himself he was fat.
I bet you use mine. You wouldn't fit. They'd be lost in it as well. You'd be lost in it again.
The buttons out.
Stop it now, guy.
You would. You're a big fat heart. That's probably getting too heavy for your little hand, is it?
No, it'll be alright, guy. Okay. Could you try and get it in?
I'm getting it in.
Typical. Your wife's always saying that to me. Oh, no.
Oh, look at that.
Well done, guy.
You leave my wife over. You can't fucking handle your own.
That's fucking true.
That's what she fucking likes.
I know. Because I'm not a misogynist. I'm basically a feminist. A massive penis.
Women have equality, you know? So you have to deal with that, there.
I'm all for equality.
Would they be? And have to do 30 more hours a week.
Of opportunity, not outcome. There's a big difference. Look at your fucking baby fingers on you.
Oh, me?
Yeah, look at
them. Fucking gloves. So
I'm
tight.
Fitting the gloves.
They're so fucking tight, they're stopping the blood going to your fingers. Look, I'd rather lose my fingers than have dirty hands.
Jeez, I cannot get over. I don't know how Greg's hands last. The fucking arms are connected to.
Don't bend that filter, Greg.
Careful now, Greg. I know. Go easy. Gently.
You know, how is it that, right? I met you there with the boss and I'm told 3 times to go get a timber and he won't go.
I'd be afraid I'm going to miss the crack. I'm on my own all morning here. I'm lonely. Do you care even?
Like
doing what he was told. That's true. She has a Susu engine or some engine, aren't they? The Komatsu Whisperer was telling me, know how to stay cool, so, well, see that? There's like millions of trained worms. You can't open that, they'll all get out. There's all the trained worms. They keep cool wiggling around in there.
They stay up in the dirt.
How many of them have you out now?
I won't lie. The production has gone down.
Spill it away there.
Yeah, Greg. Spill the oil there. It's only the dearest oil you can buy.
You know, I was talking to a lad the other day and was giving him about Komatsus. And I told him to go fuck himself. You know what he said to me?
Oh, yeah.
I was fucking bullying with him. He says, oh, Komatsus are like deep fat fryers. You won't starve, but they're not good for you.
He's a red pundit, wasn't he?
Yeah, he's a fucking dickhead.
Fucking hell.
Married to Protestants as well.
He wants like you.
Yeah. Probably why he's so bitter. I'm on ludicrous money per hour. Gary was just saying this is the most expensive vial that you could have, especially with me carrying it, and I should be getting out timber.
Refuse to go timber. Point blank refuses to
go timber. I'm going to go back at it now sometime. Oh, go do work, go do work. We're paying your head fucking money. Pricks. Did you ever see such excitement? Happy? Me and Lily were in doing a little bit of work and Lily said, Daddy, look at the sky outside, it's gorgeous. You know what? She is right. That is very, very nice.
Right.
Maybe someday, instead of being in here working and you, when you're old enough, we can be out drinking it.
What drink do you think I like?
Gin, or maybe wine, like your mother.
No, I'm not doing a mummy on it.
How about a fine cognac like me?
Maybe.
That's what I like to hear. I think I'm going to call it a night. I thought I heard him. No, he's grand. Must be hearing things. Got a good few orders done. They're off for the courier. And that's on post. Two of them are going to New Zealand. And now I'm going to have a drink of water. And I'm going to, I suppose, bring down her baby bottle and a nappy. Go to bed. Vicky will probably be home around 11:30 tonight or 11:45, I'm not sure. It'll be too late to be doing the bit of reading anyway, do you know what I mean?